Hi, I'm Dr. Laura Schlessinger, and welcome to our YouTube video blog channel thing, where I get to answer your questions. And this one's from Frank. I have a 14-year-old girl who has, out of nowhere, become impossible to live with. Took her till 14, huh? Everything is an argument or a fight. That sounds typical. She's trying to talk to 20-something-year-old boys, men that are in the service, which has me torn between my support for what they are doing for us and the fact that this is not right. You shouldn't be torn between those things. Servicemen shouldn't be hitting on 14-year-old girls, okay? And as a matter of fact, I think you should report them to their superior officers. She won't do chores without a fight and then does them only halfway. She won't keep her room clean when I hit her up on it. She says it's clean enough for her. Taking away and not letting her do things and have things doesn't work. I went into her email and found a chat room where she was talking to a serviceman telling him she has no life, that her dad's a jerk, her mother is a witch, and her older sister is an idiot. When I asked what this was all about, she blew up and would say nothing. It's getting to the point where I like it better when she's gone for a day or night. I want my little girl back, the one who used to cling to me and have to be in my lap when watching TV. What can I do? First of all, she's well into the adolescent, post-pubertal, still developing all her parts, if you get my drift, and she's not going to be cuddling up with you on the lap watching TV because she's not a baby anymore. She's beginning her evolution into being a young woman. And first of all, I have told parents a million times, and I'm so frustrated with this, the cell phones with the emails and the text messages and the internet access shouldn't be there because that opens another world that she shouldn't be walking into, for goodness sake. And you're assuming it's a 20-year-old service person. We don't know who it is on the other end. It could be some 50-year-old pervert, okay? So, you know, monitoring this is very important. Getting her involved in activities that are fun for her, exciting, where you're all cheering her and it isn't all just a tug of war where do this, do this, do this. It's just making it a hostile environment. At this point, you should walk into a room and say, wow, gosh, I really appreciate that you made it a little bit neater. Now, she probably didn't, but maybe it looks a little bit neater. In other words, it's not this anymore, it's this. So you start finding little compliments. You ask her to go for a bike ride with you. You start investing and involving with her in a different way than you ever have before. She's starting to become an adult. She's way far from it, but she's starting to become adult. So she's going to need you to relate to her like an adult, not trying to pull her back into being the little kid that you could force and manipulate all the time. So, you know, you have chores. These are the chores, and they have to be done to this extent, and then you get to blankety blank. I always thought that was a perfect way to deal with it. You want to go to that party, you want to go to that movie, you want to stay up and watch that show. Absolutely, you can do all of that. As soon as these things are done, go do it. And then when they don't do the things, you say, oh, that's too bad. I know you would have liked to have done that. So there's no yelling, there's no recrimination, and then she'll sit there and think, hell. I better do that because then I can get to do that. And then she will be making the choices. That's you being smart. And a lot of hugs and kisses. Not slurpy ones like you used to do because, you know, it's feeling a little weird to her. I'm Dr. Laura Schlessinger, and for all of you who have teenagers, good luck. And see you at our next YouTube channel video blog.